Machine learning models break. They usually don't throw errors. They fail silently, extremely silently. It's almost impossible to know when your machine learning model is not doing what you were hoping it would do on your production data. There's been a lot of very high profile examples of machine learning models behaving badly. The only way to really know what your machine learning models are doing is to log, okay, what went in and what came out. Without an experiment tracking library, this would require writing a ton of extra code to log the inputs, log the outputs, and then visualize them. You're going to want a nice way to explore them. If you log 10,000 PNGs from CIFAR-10, how do I look through those? This is time that you're not spending doing what you want to do, which is train machines to do cool stuff. We're going to demonstrate how to do this with WandbCallback. It looks really similar to normal Keras code without WNB instrumented. And then here, we're going to pull out a small subset of images. We're going to take this and we're going to pass this to WNBCallback. This is the call signature for the WandbCallback. There's lots of ways to configure it. We're going to focus on just one, which is solving this problem of how do I know what went into my model and what came out. Check out this documentation, look at the source code. You can see how to use all of these different things. What we're going to do is we're going to pass in some data using this training data keyword argument and the labels for the class names that correspond to each index. Also, we need to tell it that this is image data, so it knows to log it as an image. Callback is smart enough to know what you want out of this is you wanna run the model on these images and check it against these labels, log that at the end of each epoch. Let's take a look at the results. This will be on the project page. That's the link that comes out when you run wandb.init. Let's go to that. You can always go to your profile and find it from there. Let's take a look here. We still got the stuff that we had on the previous run here, but now we've also got these examples. So our model is not doing super great right now. We got a 40% accuracy, which is not so bad for 1 out of 10, but I'm pretty sure that is an ostrich, not a horse. It's certainly a bird of some kind. And that is a kitty. That is for sure a kitty and not a frog. We're not doing great right now. I will say this bird here in the middle, it's green in the background, brown in the foreground. That is classic deer territory. This has got sky in the background. Obviously, birds appear in front of sky, whereas deer appear in front of trees. So our model has been learning something. Probably should run it for more epochs. Maybe we should give it more capacity. With this rich media output, we can see more than just accuracy's going up, losses going down. We can see how the model is learning. I love the media logging stuff. I was always writing matplotlib code to pull out predictions from my model and plot images and try and arrange them. It was nice to learn some matplotlib and get practice with it, but it's not what I was getting my PhD in, you know? I was getting my PhD in neural networks, not matplotlib.